Hello, my name is Priyanka. I'm a research scholar at Dr. Ambedkar Institute of Technology, Bangalore. And one more author for this paper is Dr. Mary Cherry, and she's a professor at Dr. KIT College, Bangalore. I'm going to present our paper that is a novel approach to virtual machine migration in cloud computing environment, a survey. So it was published under Volume 7, Issue 1 and January edition. Our paper ID is ART2017-8255. So in today's pandemic world, where because of COVID, people are supposed to work from home. So this is creating a popularity for the cloud. We are using many cloud applications for online teaching, or it might be any meeting you want to conduct. So all these are possible because of cloud. So we have to know why it is becoming popular, and how virtual machine helps in doing this, and why virtual migration is required, we'll see in this introduction. Cloud computing is a computing over internet, the best method of accessing and managing user data without any requirement of infrastructure at user location. So user can access their data remotely from any location at less cost, and guarantees that management other security issues, related issues. So here, what I mean to say here is, the cloud, if you are accessing, then you can keep your documents, files, and whatever the important things you required, you can keep it in a cloud. You can access anytime, anywhere, remotely, with an internet connection. So instead of keeping all your documents or any software at the home, or in a desktop, or in an office laptop, or a desktop, you can save your files in a cloud. So you can access whenever you want. So this is the main advantage is cloud computing. So let's know what is virtualization. Virtualization is creates virtual environment on a single physical computer, abstracting the hardware details, which allow us to use multiple instances of operating system. So why we need virtualization? Because to create the operating system. So this helps us to create a virtual machine. Virtualization also allows VM migration from one machine to another machine. It divides the computer resources into different machines by partitioning the hardware and software. Thus, it reduces the overall cost in space, power, and other infrastructure. So this virtualization layer is the one which helps us to create a virtual machine. So it helps us to reduce the physical infrastructure costs. So it will helpful for us to reduce the power and also the infrastructure. And next we have to know why this virtualization is helpful. And next is hypervisor. Hypervisor, or virtual machine monitor, is a piece of computer software, firmware, or hardware that creates and runs the virtual machine. A computer on which the hypervisor is running, one or more virtual machine is defined as a host machine. Each physical virtual machine is called as a guest machine. It manages the multiple operating system on a single operating computer system. This is the software which helps us to create. It's a layer on virtualization is a layer on which the hypervisor layer will be running. This is the one which creates the virtual machine. Suppose you have a laptop. In a laptop, you have a 2007 or 2010 Windows, and in a virtual machine you want to have Ubuntu or Linux as an operating system. Then you can use this hypervisor layer or a virtualization to create a virtual machine. This helps us to share your processor, memory, and other storage, as I can see in the diagram. Here we have a physical hardware, that is CPU, memory, network, operating system, and storage. And when a layer is called as a hypervisor, and you are creating a virtual machine, you can see here you are sharing all your resources to a virtual machine. So suppose you have a 500 GB of a storage, you can give 100 GB for each virtual machine. And the main advantage of using virtual machine is that you can use whenever you want and shut it down. So it will be in your present in a physical machine, but you can use whenever you want. This is hypervisor layer which creates that. and even the CPU. You can divide your CPU processing. Here you can see the orange color. We are dividing it, sharing for each virtual machine. Even the memory, the blue color, network, the yellow color, operating system. Here if you have a Windows 10, here you can put other operating system. That is the main advantage of using this. You can have multiple OS instances. So next we have to know the types of hypervisor. Hypervisor, we have type 1 and type 2. Type 1 is a metal hypervisor. It is independent from operating system. Next is type 2, hosted hypervisor, whereas it has operating application on top of the existing operating system. It's also known as software virtualization, whereas type 1 is directly on the hardware of the host and can monitor operating system that run above the hypervisor. This makes it easy for end user to run the virtual machine on a computing device. So the main difference between type 1 and type 2 is type 1 is independent from the operating system, whereas a type 2 runs on the top of the operating system. So we call it a software virtualization. It supports the guest virtual machines like and gives the resources such as CPU, memory and disk. So it makes it easy for user to run virtual machines. So we have to know why this virtual migration is required and why it is important. Let's know. First, it is used in load balancing for maintaining the server, then recovery from host failure and reducing the resource hotspot. Load balancing helps to move the VMs to the other host where it is less busy, but the host must be having enough space so we can transfer. Maintenance, we can switch off the VMs so the power is reduced. So recovery from the host failure, restart the VM. Suppose you don't have enough space in your host, we can migrate this VM to the other host where you can restart and you can save your so you can avoid the VM crashing, reducing resource hotspot. So it means that you don't have enough resources available in your laptop or your desktop or consider a server. So what we are doing is we are shifting it. So we have mere migration type, that is a non-live migration and a live migration. In non-live migration, we are shutting down the VM on the host 1 and we are restarting on the host 2. Whereas a live migration, we are copying the memory pages, RAM, from one VM from the one host to the another host. We are transferring from the one source machine to another source machine. For live migration, we have two types, that is a post copy and the pre-copy. For what we are doing in live non-live migration, in non-live migration, we are completely shutting down the source machine until the memory pages are copied, then we are restarting on the host too. Whereas in live migration, we are avoiding shutting of VMs, so simultaneously we are transferring the memory page from the source machine to our destination machine. So let's know what is this pre-copy memory migration. In this, we have two phases, that is a warm-up phase and stop and copy phase. In pre-copy memory migration, the hypervisor typically copies all memory pages from source to destination while the VM is still running on the source. If some memory pages change during this process, they should be recopied to the destination, the page we call it as a dirty page. Whereas in stop and recopy phase, after the warm-up phase, the VM will be stopped on the original host, the remaining dirty pages will be copied to destination and the VM will be resumed on the destination host. The time between stopping the VM on the original host and resuming it on the destination is called as a downtime and ranges from few milliseconds to second according to the size of memory and application running on the VM. So here we are transferring the memory pages from source to destination. What happening here is some memory pages which are required in the destination, if it is not available, then we call it as a dirty page. The downtime is, you can see in this diagram here, the downtime occurs when there is a dirty page. means if a page is not available at destination, it still is in a source. If some changes is happening in the source, then this downtime will occur. So we can see in this diagram here, we have n number of memory pages we are transferring, and at the last we can see that a downtime. Downtime we have to avoid because it takes milliseconds, and sometimes if the task is not completely whatever the user is requesting, we have to respond for the request, and suddenly if that page is memory page is not available, then it is we cannot respond to the client request. So there is a major drawback of this pre-copy approach. Next we will see what will happen in post-copy migration. Post-copy migration is initiated by suspending the VM at the source, with the VM suspended, the minimal subset execution of the VM CPU state register transfer to the target. The VM is then resumed at the target. Currently, the source actively pushes the remaining memory pages of the VM to our target. An activity is known as pre-paging. At the target, if VM tries to access the page that has not yet been transferred, it generates a page fault. So this is a disadvantage of post-copy migration, that is a page fault. These faults, known as the network faults, are trapped at the target and redirect to the source, which respond with a faulted page. See here, in post-copy migration is initiated by suspending the VM at the source, means we have suspending the execution at the source and restarting at the destination by taking some CPU state register. And this, what is happening is the source actively pushes the remaining pages to target, and sometimes we call it as a pre-paging. But what is happening is the page fault will occur. Why this page fault will occur? Because some of the memory pages will be in the source and we are starting at the destination, and this fault will occur. See, you can see the downtime for transferring the VM from one host to another host, and the downtime will be at the beginning of the session, whereas in a pre-copy it will be at the end of the session. So this is the main difference between a pre-copy and post-copy technique. Whereas in pre-copy, the downtime at the end, whereas in the post-copy the downtime will be at the beginning of the session, and there in pre-copy there dirty page will occur, whereas in post-copy there is a page fault that will occur. So we have to make sure that before migrating the VM, this should not occur. So the efficiency of this migration will be increased. So next we will see the techniques that are available for pre-copy migration. So here we have improved time series based live migration technique. Here it works well with structured and unstructured data. It is not applied to the alternative modify pages. Next we have bitmap algorithm with the help of a matrix. When the pages having the weight more than the threshold value will not be forwarded to destination host, the strength of this algorithm is only based on the threshold value. This is the drawback of this algorithm. First, a fast live migration, the pages for user process are given page frame number and transmitted from the source to destination using the storage area network. The drawback of this represents the quality of service. And next, two-phase pre-copy strategy, it improves the algorithm to meet the constraints of a given downtime of certain class of application. It's based on the application, the two-phase pre-copy works well. So we have pros and cons by using these techniques. So concluding this article by telling that live migration is used for load balancing. Because if you are using a non-live migration, what is happening is you're completely shutting down the system, and it takes a lot of time, and you cannot restart a task which are already running in the VM. You cannot restart as soon as you transfer. It takes some time, so there the time will be wasted. So if you are using live migration, it minimizes the migration time, downtime, and increase the performance. And it is tough to judge the different proposed method as them is implemented in various architecture and platform. It is hard to standardize the performance of a migration. So each proposed method will be having certain its own drawback and introduce an overhead. So based on your requirement and based on the system configuration, you can use the techniques that is suits for your applications and which increases the performance. So here I want to end my presentation by telling that we have to develop such a model where it minimizes the migration time, maximizes the resource, and reduces the power consumption. We have to all three criteria should be taken care while migrating the VMs. Why this VM migration is required? Because of a huge data centers today we are using, it creates an enormous amount of energy and power will be consumed more. And user requesting the application is also more. So as per the user requirement, we have to develop a model which is helpful for the VM migration and also for the data centers. Thank you.